I'm Corbett Wall with DV Auction, here with your feeder flash for Thursday, September the 14th, and these fats may be looking up. I know we've been in a down market on the fat side for several weeks here, and it just looked like we didn't have a bottom to it, and we haven't been selling enough cattle and starting to lose some of the currentness that the industry has had, and we've got a lot of heavy market-ready supplies, we've got heavy carcasses, and we just got done with a holiday week, so that was a lighter kill and things were kind of stacking up. But all of a sudden you look around and these packers are showing signs that they need some cattle, and they've already pretty much tipped their hand that they need some, and your feeders already dug in last week pretty much showing that they're not going to give up any more market position. So it's lining up to be steady at worst, and I think maybe gain a buck or two. But look at the board. On Wednesday, live cattle futures, the October contract was up $1.27 to end the day on Wednesday at $107.55. There's another positive. Your feeder cattle board, the October, was up 47 cents on Wednesday to end the day at $149.62. And on your fats, we had a few sell through Tuesday there, come through mandatory price reporting, about 3,100 head there, and selling from 103 to 105. Well, that's about as good as what they got last week, selling real early in the week there, so that's a tip of the hand. Have had a couple deals on a dress basis, 164 to 165. That would be a little bit weaker. But on the Fed Cattle Exchange, which is really getting light, they just had a little over 1,000 head on offer this time, and a light run. And normally, if the packers didn't want to kind of use that as a token, they wouldn't have even paid any attention to it. But they did go on there and buy one pin, or got one pin bought, 128 head in the pin there at 104.75. Now, I know that's not 105, and it's not better than what we had, but just reading between the lines, you can see that it's looking like the packers are needing some cattle. And if these feeders continue to dig in, the thing is your cattle feeders don't have a basis anymore. So when they had a basis there, a $3 or $4 basis, it was easier to get them to cave in for a buck or two less, because they knew they were going to gain it back on the basis. But the basis has gone away. We got a negative basis, so they're taking a little hit there too, and the cattle are losing money, and they've just kind of had it, and they're just tired of taking less money. And albeit the packers don't need a whole lot of cattle, because they get most of their cattle through contracts or highs for the week or whatever, but they still have to get a few to fill in on the negotiated. You look at your feeder cattle markets, your real-time index on Beef Market Central, based on an 800-pound steer late Wednesday, was at 148.47, up 74 cents. So we have a lot of big sales pumping in there on a Wednesday. You look at Wednesday, your biggest sale, of course, is OKC West in El Reno, Oklahoma. 10,300 head on offer there, counting the Tuesday sale, which had about 2,200 calves, and then a little over 8,000 yearlings on Wednesday. Your feeder steers $3 to $5 higher, and these yearlings have been selling good all week long, and they continue to go through the week selling this way, and it's not just because your early week sales didn't have an offering last week because of the Labor Day holiday. No, we're getting into 3 to 5 higher on top of the higher last week, so it's awful good. Feeder heifers were steady to firm. Your calves on Tuesday were $2 to $3 higher. Look at some quotes on El Reno on your automated market report on Beef Market Central there. On the 7 weights, 1,704 head of 7 weight steers averaged 752 at 152.46. That's up $7.11 compared to the weighted average week before. And on the 8 weights, 1,722 head of 8 weight steers just on Wednesday there. The average 850 pounds, so that was a good test of the highs and lows eights. Average 143.98, up 317. And I thought, why not? Let's pencil out some of those cattle there just on the average and see how things are coming together. But you had over 1,700 head, and they average 144. So you take that 144 times 850 pound steer, that's $1,225 a head. You need to put at least 600 pounds on them to get them up to about 14 and a half. Nobody sells cattle any lighter than that anymore, not on purpose anyway. You know, counting your expenses and your freight, getting them there and working them and all that kind of stuff, even as cheap as feed is, still a 60 cent gain. And you know, you can call that way too cheap, and some guys will say that's too high, but it's what I'm working with, is a 60 cent gain. And that's 6 times 6 is 36, if I remember right. $360 on top of that $1,225 gives you $1,585 in that 1,450-pound steer, and that breaks even at 109. So really kind of right in there, because if you look at the board early next year, it's better than that. So that's how come your yearlings are selling so good, that and the fact that there's not very many of them left. And every day that goes by, there's fewer and fewer of them, and the only thing there will be left is some backgrounded calfy type cattle that are way heavy but aren't going to perform near as well in the feedlot. But look at another market on Wednesday, Dodge City, Kansas, 2,700 head. Feeders there $3 to $6 higher, and they had a good sale last week, so that's really good. Individual quote that I thought was very impressive at St. Joe Stockyards, my old stomping grounds there, at 10 o'clock on Wednesday morning, had 108 head of steers, weighed 739 at 167.75. And I was informed also that those cattle were assembled professionally by my buddy Dwayne Penny there of Bowes and Penny, a commission firm at St. Joe Stockyards. And if any of you know Dwayne, you know that most of the time he has a wore out whip coming from his right hand like an appendage, and a lot of us call it the magic wand, and he likes that quite a bit. So a shout out to my buddy Dwayne Penny and his magic wand. But he assembled those cattle and bought those cattle for those guys to background. They turned them out on grass and no doubt made some good money on there and got some good green yearlings for somebody to take to feed. But another individual quote out of Torrington Livestock Markets right before 3 o'clock in the afternoon on Wednesday, 133 head of big steers, weighed 972 at 145.75. That's your feeder flash for Thursday.